How's it going, everyone? Kellen Reck here, and today we're talking depth of field. What is it? How do we affect it? And how can we make everything look boss? Let's talk depth of field. It's the range of what is in focus in your shot. It's the distance from the nearest object in focus to the furthest object in focus within your frame. You can see in this photo from photographylife.com that we can have a different depth of field. On one end, we've got a narrow depth of field, and on the other end, we have a large or wide depth of field. This means that we can have varying distances of what's in focus within our shot. So, what are the ways that we can affect this? Well, there's three. You've got aperture, you've got the distance to your subject, and you've also got the focal length of your lens. So, let's talk about the first here, aperture. Aperture is the opening in your lens. Now, the wider that opening, the smaller the actual number, the shallower the depth of field. So if we're shooting an interview at f1.8 like this, we've got a shallow depth of field. I'm in focus, the background is out of focus. If we crank that aperture up to something like f18, where we have a very closed down aperture, you're gonna start to see a lot more in focus. Our depth of field gets wider. So everything behind me is gonna be in focus in addition to myself. The second way to affect depth of field is distance to your subject. The closer you are to your subject, the shallower the depth of field. If the camera's very close to me, there's gonna be a much shallower depth of field versus if the camera's much farther away. The things that are behind and in front of me might be in focus if the camera's much further away. The closer we are to an object, the shallower the depth of field. The further away, the wider the depth of field. And finally, the focal length of your lens affects depth of field. The longer the focal length, the shallower the depth of field. So let's take a 100mm lens. All of the shots on a 100mm lens will have a much shallower depth of field than on a wide lens like a 16mm. All three of these things affect the way that light is hitting your camera sensor and thus are giving you those varying depth of fields. Now, why is it important to understand depth of field and how to affect it? Well, it can make a big difference in your photography and your filmmaking. Say you're a landscape photographer and you want this nice, beautiful landscape shot. You want everything in focus. Well, you need to know how to do that. You need to know that you want to close down your aperture. You need to know that you want some distance and you want to use a wide lens, and that's going to help you get everything in focus. Whereas a filmmaker might want to shoot an interview that has a nice out of focus background and really isolates your subject. Well, you need to know how to get a shallow depth of field for that. So you might want a telephoto lens and the aperture to be opened up nice and wide, and that'll help give you that shallow depth of field. So there's different ways that you can use these three options of affecting depth of field to give you the stylized shots that you want. I hope that this video helped you. I have another video on camera basics that kind of has an overview of different aspects of photography and filmmaking, but I wanted to dive deep into depth of field to give you an understanding of how you can use it and how you can affect it and improve your own skills. So thanks for checking out the video. We'll be back next week. I appreciate you guys watching. If you enjoyed, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, leave a comment, and we'll check you back in the next one.